Good? Having a good time? We just got here. You're going to have to fill us in. You've been here for a day or so, 2 days, what, yeah? Yeah? You came from far and wide to spread your vision of love and solstice happiness, yes? Welcome in the summer. Feels good. Summer in Oregon. Father's Day Eve. Welcome to the fathers. Feeling good, feeling frisky, having fun, got a B3. We'll be right back. Well, I love music, and you love to dance. When we're together, it's the perfect romance. Two bodies intertwined, getting strange and sweet. Moving back and forth from my hands to the soles of your feet, from my soul to the soles of your feet, from my soul to your soul to the soul. Music school on drums and lead vocals, Vitamin D Dave Brogan.
got cities on every coast. A chicken shack, people see him dancing toast. Well, falling dominoes, falling down your soul. Falling dominoes, don't always fall on rose. Don't always fall on rose. The sides got broke, then my stash got pulled. Got shaken up a bit with my eyes closed. Now I'm all shook up and I'm turned around. I'm feeling like a great wall coming to town.
Thank you.
You guys are good? I'd like to dedicate this next number to all the fathers out there. Happy Father's Day. We wouldn't be here without you. The fathers are very important, you know. And the fathers get ragged on, you know. It's hard to be a dad sometimes, you know. You don't appreciate your dad when you're there with him, you know. And sometimes you're butting heads, but it's important, you know. Those roots, the roots and the roots and the branches, you got to have both. And there's your dad. My dad was awesome, you know. He taught me to play guitar, which was awesome. And, you know, he used to help us out in the early days. So I'd like to raise a toast to my dad and your dads and everybody and all the dads here on the stage. And, of course, the moms, you know, but the dads specifically, because this is the day. So here's to you, Dad. Thanks. So sweet when it touches your lips. Thank you.
social modesty. It's positive and always true. With your modesty talking negatively, it's when everybody feels negative too. It's why she gotta give a little bit of comfort in. Just believe in what she does. We got to try just a little bit harder. But let it shine just a little bit brighter. We got to walk just a little bit taller. Cause I feel the sun.
Yeah, we want to bring a good friend of ours we don't see enough, Mr. Asher Flair. You guys might be familiar with him. He's the man of the festival, I think. Artist at large.
Well, it's great to be back at Four Peaks. We were here, maybe it was like the first or second one. It was a way long time ago. The music was down the hill. It was a totally different vibe. Really fun, but I gotta say, it's come a long way. You guys, this kicking it. It's good. It's really nice up here. Really nice. When we rolled in, we came down the road, and these guys in the yellow right there, the first thing I saw, the music was good. It was a nice thing to stroll into. Kind of psychedelic.
Thank you.
a crazy mixed up world full of contradictions, and that's why it hurts so bad sometimes, but that's also why it's fun. And I'm gonna love you like I got something to prove. Feeling good in the pocket like an old school groove. Living in a plastic bubble, a bubble in a plastic world.
Asher Falero sitting in. Sounding nice, man. It's good to play with you.
Hot tub. What are you guys doing? It got all dark. I like it. I get nervous when I can see you so precisely. You guys are still having fun? Good. You don't... Thank you. Thank you for the show of enthusiasm. Makes me feel good. Man, poor man's whiskey pulled it off, man. Boy. This thing's a beauty. You know, it is not easy to get a festival off the ground. We've talked about it for years, and it's just always... It's scary, you know, to just think... If you do it, will people come? Will the ritual expand? Will it just be you and your friends? I mean, that some levels that's enough, but you gotta have, you know, it's gotta grow. And so the Four Peaks has grown. So here's to the Four Peaks. We're gonna bring out, in the name of Burning Passion Festival, Summer Solstice, we're gonna bring out the Tea Sisters to help us with this little number, this little ditty. I think these girls are closing the festival tomorrow during the day. This is where they started. They're gonna start a simmer. It's gonna burn all night long.
Oh yeah.
Romeo and Juliet, Samson and Delilah, baby, you can bet a love me couldn't deny.
Sisters, everybody. We did a whole tour with them in February, so we got some songs down. So maybe if any of y'all going to be at High Sierra. Anyone coming to High Sierra? All right, it's right down the road. How about anyone coming to Oregon Country Fair? Yeah, we're going to be there. ALO's playing. It's ALO's first time at Oregon Country Fair, so.
Well, it's not our first time.
Well, it's our first time playing in the fair. We busked once many, many a year ago, but. Our first official, so
we had
we're
a great,
psyched about it.
Great time, yeah. First time. Akiko, remember Akiko? You guys want to get a little weird? Just like a little bit. Take the reins off. Let it kind of float off for a little bit. We might need more darkness on the stage. We're like a red hue. Can we go more red? I don't know. Is that with the lights? Is that possible? More redness? Is that redness? Or blueness even would be. Lights, anybody? Anybody have control? It's like a dial somewhere. Dial it in. We'd like to tell you a story, take you on a shamanic journey, if we can. Help you to release your inner animal. If you've been holding onto your inner animal, now's the time to just let that inner animal float off into the atmosphere. Just let that thing go. Oh, there we go. Oh, thank you. Inner animals need... They need a little bit of darkness to let go. They don't want to come out at night. So many of them are nocturnal, the inner animals. The raccoons and the possums and the skunks. I captured a rat the other day. I've had rats in my life. Rats and coyotes. I drove my daughter to school and there was a coyote out at 8:30 in the morning. That never happens. What was he? He was looking for water or something. And he was on the side of the road. He stopped and he stared at me. And he said, He said, is that you, Zach? And I said, yes, Coyote, that's me. How have you been? And he said, I've been fine, I'm thirsty. And I said, ah, Coyote, me too. Me too, Coyote. Me too. But the rats, boy, the rats, it was a strange sound in the middle of the night. My wife was gone, she left me with the kids. And suddenly my daughter, my oldest daughter, Jane, there was a scratching noise. And she said, Dad, come in. Something's, the dog's freaking out. There's something under the bed. And I thought, oh, God, no. Because I'm a little paranoid of rats. They scare me. Something, even though we had pet rats and they were very nice, but just the thought of them running around like creatures in the night, it was scaring me. But we have these live animal traps. And I set one in her room. And she slept in the office that night. And in the morning... We captured this little kangaroo rat, and he was the sweetest little thing. He had these big ears, and I let him out into the woods, and he hopped. And I thought, oh, awesome, we have one rat in the house. He must have just stumbled in, and that was it. But my neighbor John said, oh, no, that's not it. Dude, there's never one rat. There are just lots of rats. They don't just travel by themselves. The rats are not loners. They like community. They like groups. They want to have festivals. They want to be with each other and do things and climb. And so sure enough, a few days later, there was another rat in the garage. And we caught him. And a few days after that, there was a third rat. And the great thing was it got us to clean out the pantry, which had become a mess. It was disturbing. And cleaned out the garage. It was also disturbing, you know, to find these things and clean it out. And then there was the wood pile on the side of the house, and I thought, well, that looks like a rat's nest. And so I started to remove the wood, and I started to kind of pull the pieces out, and I pulled them out, and then I started to move this big, it was a 10-foot 2x4, and I pulled it, and I saw one rat spring out and run under the fence, and I thought, oh God, and I kind of screamed, and then I moved it a little more, and another one went, and another one went, and another one went, and all of a sudden there was dozens of rats, and they were all running, and I was a little scared. I called my wife, and she sort of chuckled, and then the rats were gone. I think they're gone. So, yeah, applause. I don't know. Was it my bravery? Was it my What it was the rats got me to clean the yard. They got me to recognize that the side of the yard had fallen apart. Sometimes there's forces in our life that we wouldn't ask for, but sometimes they're beneficial. They don't seem like benevolent spirits. They seem like sort of these, it's like sort of an ambiguous trickster energy, and you think it's all on, and then all of a sudden it's all off, and you're like, ah, God, and you think that you're driving to Bend, but you're not driving to Bend. You're about to run out of gas, and you thought you're in your Toyota Yaris, and you thought, oh my God, what is happening? I hate the Toyota Yaris, but it gets such good mileage, but it's not fun to drive, and you're driving in the Yaris, and it's almost out of gas, and you're texting the rest of the guys on the cell phone, and you're tripping out, you're freaking out, you're wondering, but thank God, only 40 minutes to Bend, and most of it's downhill. You get to Bend, and there's raw kombucha being sold in a dispensary at the gas station, and you think, what? We've made it, we've died and gone to heaven. Thank you. Coconut-infused kombucha. It's wonderful at the gas station on the outskirts of Bend. It's not even Bend, it's the other town about the river. I'm just saying, sister. Sometimes there's benevolent spirits and sometimes they're sister. Not the kinds that you would wish were there. You wouldn't wish for them, but they're there. This is a song about those kinds of benevolent spirits and how they take you by the cojones sometimes, take you by the head, the scalp, and you think you're headed in the right direction, and they turn you around and they whisk you like a big tornado. And they get you to write songs and perform them in front of people at the Four Peaks Music Festival. Lava, high on Vapor like a wind, like a feeling of freedom that comes from within. like a vapor, like a wind, like a feeling of freedom that comes from within. Like a vapor, like a wind, like a feeling of freedom that comes from within. Like a vapor, like a wind, like a feeling of freedom that comes from within. Mystical and magical shaman on the scene. Can take up to 12 people on a spiritual journey. Came into our room waving a little sad. We'd like to send you off with a love song. The ALO man is all about love. It's the thing that keeps us together. Gives us a reason to keep playing music together. I don't know if this on the way. As long as I've got you, I can take the twists and turns, the ups and downs, the lessons learned in a mystery. That's me and you. Finish off one episode. That's it for us. We got a skedaddle. But I think there's more music after this. Thanks to everybody for having us. That's Lebo, Dave, and Steve. I'm Zach. We're the ALO band. We'll be at the Oregon Country Fair Friday night, High Sierra Music Festival. We got a whole nationwide tour happening in the fall. Gonna go all around, tell your friends. We got a new record coming out. We're excited, we're feeling renewed, and we hope you are too. Happy solstice.
ALO, everybody. Make some noise. Do you want one more? What? Okay. We can do this.
Yeah, you guys want another one? Well, good, we're in agreeance because we want to play another one, so that's good.
All that leaving the stage was just a trick. I just want to come back out. We would play forever, but you know, there's ways you're supposed to do this. There's a custom to a tradition.
Well, this one, if you want, you can get out of the blues if you want for this one. Talking about the lights, that is.
What color is it, Lebo?
I don't know.
This next one.
It's probably reds and like oranges. Reds and oranges.
The blues were good though for that whole Colomana thing.
That was great. Intense. That was awesome.
I'd say orange and gold.
Oh, man, look
orange
at those balloons. Gold. God, what people are doing
the
with
the color
balloons
of a burning
these
piece of charcoal.
It's amazing. God, what is that? It's like a glowing alien head. It's come for me.
Yeah, oh yeah, that's nice, that's nice.
You guys want to do anything special this one? We want to make this one count. This is something, we got to do something right now. I don't know what it is, but we got to do something that we're all going to remember. I think it's going to involve the people with the balloons and the bottle of champagne. I'm just putting stuff out there. What is that, a Santa Claus? I can't, it's a unicorn, it's a unicorn. Yeah, it's going to involve the unicorn. This is the time. If you've been holding something back, now's the time. You got the electric jump rope and the balloon people, and I got a laser, and now's the time, now's the time. Big C. As it was in the beginning. The road is long and windy, like a good mystery unfolding. It twists and turns in colorful subplots and sunburns and fake out endings. Sometimes my patience in the whole process starts bending as I attempt to unravel the web by traversing and rehearsing and perversing and reversing along the doubt-laden extension cord threads of my life. And in this life we're free to dream whenever we want to, but that doesn't mean that your dreams are gonna come true. Instead, as a way of getting us to move, life dangles your dreams in front of you, and unable to resist the temptation, we continue. Well, it's clear to me that this life is gonna be all about the dangling possibilities that keep turning in and turning out. It's clear to me that this life is gonna be all about the dangling possibilities. The road is long and windy, full of twists and turns. But before you can rise from the ashes, you gotta burn, baby, burn.
love the day, I 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 love the day.
Thank you so much, everybody. Thanks so much for spending your evening with us and for having us at this wonderful festival. Thanks to Poor Man's Whiskey and all the folks that make this happen. And we'll see you later this month, or rather in the middle of next month, down the road at Oregon Country Fair. Y'all be well till then. Take it easy.
We want to give a special thank you to Stacy for throwing this shindig. And here she is. You can thank her yourself. This is what a festival. We want to give her this bottle of champagne. And this is for you.
For Stacy. For doing it. For bringing us all together.
Up here again. This is not about me. I did not want to be up here. But I wanted to thank everybody here. It's about you guys. I want to thank everybody that's a part of this. Volunteers, sponsors, everybody involved, the bands. I mean, obviously, it's about the music. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And let's go rock all night long to Polecat, Acorn, whoever else wants to sit in. Let's do it. Thank you so much for making this happen. See you here next year, same time.
Woo! All right. Y'all got a good one here. We'll see you soon.